moving past the liquor stores and screaming couples, past the half-lit open sign and trash that scatters like leaves onto the street. There are hundreds of invisible people with me, clutching steel coffee and fixing their silent stares on signs, newspapers, metro schedules. I want to find beauty or at least comfort in this place, in the drunken laughter or the cafe latte or the flower shops and hot dog sellers, but it's missing. No junkies copping or couples kissing. No old women pining about aches that were pain in the dull weather. As we shuffle onto the rail, a well-primed woman flushes under my absent stare, and the man with the laptop in the back takes a seat as the pregnant woman stands against the door. Everyone shudders at the sound of the coffer in the back and the cell phone talker in the front, as we retreat to our private thoughts for a few short moments. One by one we make our way out, returning to our empty homes, angry wives, overdue bills, second jobs, troubled teenagers, and other assorted, privately held, eclectic miseries. Visible again and alone in our thoughts, everyone moving silently as the stars stare down from a black sheet riddled with bullet holes.
For a moment, I am saved.